back, it is time to visit with the Columbus Zoo this Saturday. And today, we are graced with the presence of one of the oldest residents at the Columbus Zoo. Not Emily. she's just here to talk about them. Who are these guys?
Good morning. That's right. These are some of my favorite animals in the whole zoo. We have Bubba and Sunny here. This is Sunny, and Bubba is having a snack with Joy right now this morning. One of his favorite keepers. And these guys are Aldabra tortoises. So this is an animal that is one of the longest lived animals in the world. They can live up to 70 or 150 years, over 150 years. So they live a very, very long time. And like I said, Bubba here is the oldest. He's 74 years old. He's the oldest animal in the zoo. How cool is that?
Oh my gosh. And he doesn't look a day over 70.
He looks great, doesn't he?
He's a little wrinkly, but I feel that way always.
Oh, yes. And, you know, Aldabras are the second largest species of tortoise. Galapagos is the largest, but these guys can get up to 550 pounds, which is incredible. They're so big, and they don't have any natural predators. They're found on the Seychelles Islands off the coast of Africa, north of Madagascar.
So they're really just living the dream is what you're saying.
Absolutely, they really are. You know, it's really cool. These guys have their personal spa days. There's a type of bird called a rail that will actually come and pick parasites off of them. So they tend to really seek out affection. They love their keepers. And they seek out scratches. We actually have volunteers that come into the exhibit every day to pay attention to the tortoises, to make sure they get their morning scratches.
They're like a pet. Look at him. He's just like laying down, chowing down.
Oh, yeah. They really are living their best life all the time, I think.
What is your favorite thing about them?
You know, I think they're just so gentle. They're just gentle giants. They really are. And they're so docile. I mean, they're one of my favorite animals to visit. They're so cute when they eat. They look like little old men. And I think it's amazing. You know, we're still learning about this species of tortoise because they're so long lived that they often outlive their researchers. So, you know, there's still studies going on about these guys, but I just think, you know, seeing them in person, they're just incredible.
They're like, I'm not going to let you learn my secrets. I'm going to outlive you. That's my diabolical plan.
Right? No kidding.
That's funny. And so what's going on at the zoo these days?
You know, we obviously have the longer hours now, so we're open from 9 to 7. It's a great time to come see us. I suggest coming first thing in the morning. That's usually when a lot of the animals are super active, and you just miss these guys. We're actually taking a bath. They decided to crawl out of the water just in time, but they need to be able to control their body temperature by cooling themselves off in the water or sunning themselves. You know, these are reptiles, so they're ectothermic, so their body temperature is going to be the same as the environment. So they have to do special things like mud baths or having a good soak in the pool to cool themselves off if needed. But they're adorable, and they're most active in the morning.
How are they feeling about all the cicadas?
You know, a lot of the animals at the zoo are really enjoying the cicadas, are having a little extra snacks. These guys don't really care. I think they ignore them pretty much. You know, they're going to be grazers mostly, so they're going to eat plants. Would you like a snack? Oh, yes. So they don't mind them too much, but I will say the other animals are chowing down. There's a lot of animals that are having a lot of extra snacks with the cicadas around.
Oh, my gosh. I love them. Well, Emily, I appreciate you. Where can we find them in the zoo?
So you can come see these guys in the short.